Welcome to AKA News. I'm Chloe Jack.
And I'm Adam Monroe.
And today we're here live in studio to talk to you about the River Clyde.
But first, let's head along to the River Clyde to see our correspondent, Amy Nash.
Over to you, Amy.
I'm Amy, and I am in a very cold and very real shed, River Clyde. Okay, so currently I am in the middle course of the river, but the source is in the Lother Hills, and the mouth is in the Firth of Clyde, and the overall length is 186 kilometres. Okay, the river is in the United Kingdom and it goes through quite a few different places such as Glasgow, Greenock, Lanark and Bothwell. There are many bridges, for example, the Clyde Arch, the Erskine Bridge, the Kingston Bridge and the Glasgow Bridge. There are four main waterfalls and there are Scottish waterfalls which are called Lynns. They are the Bonnington Waterfall, Coralin, Dundafflin and Stone Byers Lynn. The highest one is 84 feet! Back to you guys in the studio!
Clyde has many land uses. The main one is industrialisation. This is shown by the amount of housing estates alongside the river. Many businesses have set up near the river too, such as the SCCC and some smaller businesses.
Farming occurs in the upper course of the river. This is due to the fact that sheep are nimble, they can walk with ease on the hills, and they can survive in the poor grass that is produced up there.
Along Clyde, there are many different endangered animals. Most endangered animals can be found at the Falls of Clyde. Some of those animals are the peregrine, falcon, roe deers and badgers.
As well as endangered animals, there are also some endangered plants along the River Clyde. For example, the rare tundra plant life that has survived on a cliff face since the last ice age.
Thanks for watching the news!
Standing in a crowded room and I can't see your face. Put your arms around me, tell me everything.